going to go through the core makeup of what the work centers are. We're going to navigate over to Enterprise Components. Down at the bottom, you're in Work Centers Dashboards. And we're going to look at Configure Pagelets. So the Pagelets is one of the key words here. This is how Pagelets are that show up in the Work Centers. That's what they're called. And then we're also going to look at filter values. And I'll get more to that in a second, but the filter values will play a key part in the Pagelets themselves. So let's look at the Pagelets first. Now, you can put in the abbreviation for what your module is. So we'll say, for instance, I'm going to look at the General Ledger. I can hit search here and pull up all the ones that are delivered. So I'm going to pop into the GL one just so that we can navigate through there. But as you can see, each of the modules does have a delivered one, and each of them would need to be configured to what your business requirements are or what the user requirements are or to manage your day. So let's look at the GL one first. On the first page of the Pagelet, you can see that there's four extra tabs besides the Work Center dashboard. Now, keep in mind on the menu items here, this comes delivered, the Work Center menu item. So unless you're gonna modify where you're gonna put the Work Center, you would leave it here. And then also too, on the Fluid Work Center, the menu item here, I wouldn't move that unless you're gonna have a custom menu item for that as well. And then down here is, like I said, the four links here: My Work, Links, Queries, and Reports and Processes. And I'm gonna go through each of those. So the My Work is designed specifically for work that is assigned to you or assigned to a manager. We'll say a manager is managing employees. You're gonna have the My Work is, it kind of does a select. It's almost like a select SQL that says, hey, based on my user ID and my filters, I'm gonna pull the work back that is specific for me or specific for the people that I'm managing. So we'll get into that in a second. Your second one is your links. Think about this as almost like your favorites. So, you know, when you're navigating over here, you can go to your recently visited places. That's kind of the same thing, but links are also important because you can put outside links into your work centers. So for instance, if you've got, now security has to be involved with this, but if you want to have links to be able to link out to other applications, you can build the links in your links area, and then you would have the security, as long as they have the credentials of it, to be able to link through, you can build that link inside of your works. The third thing is your queries. Everybody knows that sometimes you go out there and you have private queries and you have public queries. Okay, so your queries are important because if you're linking those into your work centers, they could be all of your personal queries. And they don't necessarily have to be the public. They could be your personal. That means that when you pull them into your work center, no other person can see your work center. So your work center is specific to you, so you don't have to worry about if somebody else can see these queries if you pull in private queries. And then the last thing is your reports and processes. So and we'll go over that when we get into the work center itself, but the reports, it kind of works the same way as the queries. If you have X amount of reports that you run on a daily, weekly, monthly basis, you can put all those out there with the run control pages so that it pops in and it automatically pulls in your run control. And then once you do the run control, you can run the report right from the work center. So you don't actually have to navigate to where the report kicks off. Let's look at My Work. My Work is a series of basically selects and views that allows the user to be able to see things that are available. So for instance, if you've got journals available to edit, you know, incomplete journal. So everybody knows that when you're running your GL process and you got to say, well, I need to maybe query to see how many journals are out there that haven't been posted, or maybe that are out there as valid that need to be posted, or maybe that are need to be edited. what Oracle has done is built all these basically shortcuts to allow you to be able to see these things. And then also too, you can create the filters for them to be able to say, well, I already want to see the journals that are available to edit for two business units. So for your work center, if you only have two business units that you're responsible for, you can create a filter and put part of the filter out there to say, I only want to select these two business units. It will only pull back journals that are available to edit for those. Now, of course, if you have row level security, this wouldn't have to come into play. You would only see your business units anyway, but this allows you to be flexible in what you see. As far as a manager would go, manager would use these to say, well, I'm managing five different people. I need to look at 10 different business units. So the manager might add all of those to their particular WorkCenter filter. So we'll get into that once I pull up those, but you see how they've delivered a lot of these. These are a lot of common ones used across all industries. If you scroll through here looking for Mark journals, you know, submitted for unposting, for posting, amortization, mass deletes, these are kind of the highest common ones that are used on the GL side. And all the other work centers typically do the same thing. In the my work area, it's a lot of the part of your daily processes that are done 90 to 95% of the time, and they've created these my work shortcuts for you. So I also wanted to point out over here, what are these, all these check boxes? Well, the key here is, you see where on this to show the count. Well, this is important because what they've done, and it's a really cool feature, is on the counts here, it tells you if I have journals out there available to edit, and it will actually show you how many are out there for your particular filter. So if you had a filter out there for two business units, it's going to show you what the count is. So if you have 10 of them out there, it's going to put 10 in parentheses. And then it actually, you'll have the link. I would say that because this shows you the count, they have color-coded basically to make you aware of something that needs to be done. So for instance, the link is highlighted in blue. It's highlighted in blue, that means that there's something out there that needs to be done. If it's gray, that means there's nothing out there that needs to be done. And if it's red, that means there's no filter on there. It's not gonna pull back anymore. Allows you to kind of say, oh, well, hey, I know what the issue is with here. I need to either add a filter or there's nothing available out. Every time you make a change here, so we'll just say I'm gonna go in journals pending approval. I don't want everybody to see this. I only want managers to be able to see this particular link. So what I could do is I could come in, these right here, I'll briefly touch on what these are. These are the app class packets for your classic mode and for fluid. I would not change these, come delivered. Don't change these. Down here, if I want to create the filter, but I don't want other users to see this, I don't have to apply application security to it. I can apply WorkCenter security. So I would take this button off, public here, and then I can add a permission list to say and assign it to the user, and only that user can see this link. Every change that you make, you have to activate, you have to push this button. For each of these, you'll see that there's a link on here. Activate link settings. So every time you make an uncheck here, or check box, or whatever the case may be, you must activate your work settings to be able to, for it to be able to be active over into the work center. One more thing before I go to the work centers is this button right here allows the user to personalize the display options. And how is that important? Well, if you have a lot of users, we'll just say a high volume of users, you want everybody to have the same look and feel on their work centers, then you can uncheck this box and it does not allow them to change the work center themselves. Now they can change the filters, but they just can't change the display option.